Hello and welcome to Chemistry Solutions. This tutorial is on significant figures. Let's get started. There's some general rules that we need to keep in mind when trying to determine the number of significant figures. The first is that non-zero digits are always significant. If non-zero digits are always significant, that must mean that zeros may or may not be significant. So let's talk about some rules pertaining to zeros. The first is that any zeros between non-zero digits are always significant. Also, zeros that fall at the end of a number and after the decimal point are always significant. Zeros at the beginning of a number, however, are never significant. Zeros at the beginning of a number are placeholders, and sometimes people get confused with this concept. And if this concept seems confusing to you, think about writing out this number in scientific notation. If we write the number in scientific notation, you can see that we don't need to include any zeros at the beginning of the number. And therefore, those zeros are just placeholders and not significant numbers in our value. Zeros at the end of a number without a decimal point may or may not be significant, and again we're going to distinguish those using scientific notation. Let's look at an example. 1,400,000 can be expressed many different ways, and you'll want to express that number in scientific notation with the number of zeros that you want to designate as being significant. On this slide I've listed four ways that we could write the number 1,400,000. Each with a different number of significant figures. Let's look through these examples and determine how many significant figures are in each number. In this first value, only the 1 and the 4 are significant, and none of the zeros are, so I've written this value as 1.4 times 10 to the 6th. This value has only two significant figures. In the next example I've written, I want to show that all of the zeros in my value, 1,400,000, are significant, and so I've written this number in scientific notation but including all of the zeros. Because if you remember from the rules I gave you before, any zero to the right of a number with a decimal point is significant, and this figure has seven significant figures. I've also written this value two more ways in case you want to demonstrate that only some of the zeros are significant. In this value, we have three significant zeros and five significant total figures. And in this last value, only two of those zeros are significant, and so we have four total significant figures. Let's look at some other examples and determine the number of significant figures in these values. Going back to our original rules, we talked about how all non-zero digits are significant. So this number has six significant figures. We also talked about how any zeros at the beginning of a number are never significant and that they're just placeholders. So in this value, we only have one significant figure, which would be the number 5. Remember that any zeros between non-zero digits are significant, so this value again has five significant figures because both of those zeros are going to be significant. And any zeros at the end of a number that has a decimal point are also significant, so this value has five significant figures. How do we determine the number of significant figures that we keep in calculations? Well, we have some additional rules for these. If you are adding or subtracting, you need to keep no more significant figures to the right of the decimal point than that of any of the original numbers. Well, what do I mean by that? Let's look at an example. If I'm adding 34.58 plus 2.9065 plus 67.4, it's easiest to line the numbers up with their decimal point and then draw a line after the number with the least number of decimal places. So in this example, I drew it after the 67.4. We then know that we need to keep all of the numbers to the left of this red line. And we also know that we can't keep any more numbers to the right of the decimal point than that with the least. So because 67.4 has only one number to the right of the decimal point, we can have only one number to the right of the decimal point in our final answer. In our final answer here, we have four significant figures. And then we need to use an appropriate rounding strategy to come up with our final answer of 104.9. It works the same way for subtraction. When we subtract 2294.6714 from 2300.56, again we want to line up our values and draw a line after the number with the least number of decimal places. This makes it easy to see that we will only be keeping these three significant figures. Because 2300.56 has two values after the right of the decimal point, we can only have two values to the right of the decimal point in our final answer. Although in our original numbers, 2300.56 has six significant figures, and 2294.6714 has eight significant figures, we will only be keeping three significant figures in our answer. And then keeping three significant figures will appropriately round our answer to 5.89. Well, that covers adding and subtracting, but what if we're going to multiply or divide? There's a new rule for multiplication and division, and that is that we need to keep no more significant figures than that of any of the original numbers with the fewest significant figures. If we are multiplying 24 times 578 times 32.1, you will see that 24 has two significant figures, 578 has three significant figures, and 32.1 also has three significant figures. Because 24 only has two significant figures, we can only keep two significant figures in our answer. Although when you plug these values into your calculator, you'll come up with the answer 445,291.2, we can only keep two significant figures in our final answer. And in order to avoid the ambiguity of all these zeros, it's probably best to write your answer in scientific notation. Let's try another example. Now would be a good time to pause this tutorial and try the problem on your own. Okay, when we multiply 5.782 times 3.46 and then divide by 4.8876, we'll see that 5.782 has four significant figures, 3.46 has three significant figures, and 4.8876 has five significant figures. Following our rules for multiplication and division, we'll know that we have to keep the number of significant figures as that of the original number with the lowest number of significant figures. So we need to have three significant figures in our final answer. That would give us a final answer of 4.09. What happens if we combine operations? What if we have a combination of addition or subtraction and multiplication or division? Well, first we need to follow the correct order of operations, and that tells us that we need to do anything in parentheses first. So we need to first add 56.0 and 44.845, and we'll do this like we previously talked about by lining up the decimal places and drawing a line after the number with the least number of decimal places. And when we do that, we can see that we will keep one significant figure after the decimal place. And so we will have four significant figures in our final answer. In order to avoid rounding errors, you can carry this whole number through your calculation, but we want to remember as we go over here to start multiplying that this number still only has four significant figures, which we determined before. When we look at the number we're multiplying by, 2.4, we see that this number has two significant figures. Going back to our original rules for multiplication, we know that we need to have an answer with the least number of significant figures as that of the original numbers in our problem. And so because 2.4 has the least number of significant figures with 2, we know that we can only have two significant figures in our answer. And again, it's probably best to write your answer in scientific notation. That's it for significant figures and this tutorial from Chemistry Solutions. Thanks for watching.